Here we see a typical configuration for a vertical three-phase separator. The flow stream enters the vessel through the side, as in the horizontal separator, and once again the inlet diverter separates the bulk of the gas. A downcomer is required to transmit the liquid through the oil-gas interface, so as not to disturb the oil skimming action taking place. A chimney is needed to equalize the gas pressure between the lower liquid collection section and the upper gravity settling section. The spreader or downcomer outlet is located beneath the oil-water interface. As the oil rises from this point, any free water trapped within the oil phase separates out. The water droplets flow downward, and any oil droplets trapped in the water phase tend to rise countercurrent to the water flow.
Three different methods of control are often used on vertical three-phase separators. The first is strictly level control. A regular displacer float is used to control the gas-oil interface and regulate a control valve dumping oil from the oil section. An interface float is used to control the oil-water interface and regulate the water outlet control valve.
The second method shown uses a weir to maintain the gas-oil interface level in a constant position. This method results in a better separation of water from the oil, as all the oil must rise to the height of the oil weir before exiting the vessel.
The third method uses two weirs, which eliminate the need for an interface float. The interface level is controlled by the height of the external water weir relative to the oil weir or outlet height. This is similar to the bucket and weir design for horizontal separators.